Imagine you're diving in the deep ocean, and suddenly you see a huge mouth opening up in front of you. It's a sperm whale, and it's about to swallow you whole. What would you do? How would you survive? Is it even possible? In this video, we'll explore what would happen if you were swallowed by a whale. First of all, not all whales could swallow you. Most whales are filter feeders, meaning they have baleen plates instead of teeth, and they feed on tiny plankton and krill. Their throats are too small to fit anything larger than a grapefruit. So you can rule out blue whales, humpback whales, and other baleen whales. The only whales that have teeth are the toothed whales, or odontocets. These include dolphins, porpoises, sperm whales, beaked whales, and orcas. They hunt fish, squid, seals, and sometimes other whales. But even among these whales, only one species has a throat big enough to fit a human, the sperm whale. Sperm whales are the largest of the toothed whales, and they can grow up to 20 meters long and weigh up to 50 tons. They have huge mouths that can open up to 2 meters wide, and they can swallow prey whole. They feed mainly on giant squid that live in the deep ocean, and sometimes they swallow them without even chewing. The chances of being swallowed by a sperm whale are extremely low. Sperm whales are not aggressive towards humans, and they usually avoid us. They live in remote areas of the ocean, far from where most people swim or dive. And they have echolocation, which means they can sense objects in their surroundings using sound waves. They would not mistake a human for a squid. However, let's imagine that somehow you ended up in the mouth of a sperm whale. Maybe you were diving in the wrong place at the wrong time, or maybe the whale was curious and decided to check you out. What would happen next? Well, it would not be pleasant. First of all, you would feel a lot of pressure as the whale's tongue pushed you down its throat. The throat is about 30 centimeters in diameter, so you would be squeezed tightly. You would also feel the whale's teeth scraping against your skin and bones. The teeth are conical and sharp, and they can reach up to 20 centimeters long. Then you would enter the whale's stomach. The stomach is divided into four chambers, each with a different function. The first chamber is where the food is stored and softened by enzymes. The second chamber is where the digestion begins, with more enzymes and acids breaking down the food. The third chamber is where the nutrients are absorbed into the bloodstream. And the fourth chamber is where the waste is collected and expelled. You would probably end up in the first or second chamber, depending on how hungry the whale was. There you would face several dangers: suffocation, crushing, burning, and poisoning. The chances of escaping from a whale's stomach are very slim. You would have to somehow cut through the thick stomach wall with a knife or other sharp object, which would be difficult and risky. You would also have to avoid being digested or poisoned by the stomach contents. Even if you managed to make a hole in the stomach wall, you would still have to find your way back to the mouth through the throat. This would be almost impossible, as the throat muscles would push you down instead of up. And even if you reached the mouth somehow, you would still have to hope that the whale would open its mouth and let you out. There is one case in history where a sailor claimed to have survived being swallowed by a sperm whale in 1891 off the Falkland Islands. However, this story is highly dubious and has been disputed by many experts. This is the end of the video. But if you are interested to know what if the Titanic never sank, click here and see how.